Imagine a scene like this. It's the middle of the night, or even closer to dawn than to midnight. A city center, not so loud at this hour. A very high skyscraper. It's one of the highest peaks of the whole city's overlook. There is a young woman standing on the roof of this skyscraper. She is even more of a teenager than a woman. To be precise, she's unnervingly close to the building's ledge, separating it from the immense distance to the pavement below. If you could look her in the face, you would certainly notice how worn off, tired it is. Eyes red and a little bit swollen from crying, exhausted. But you can't see it. Because she is there, on that roof, all by herself. This is the scene that Billie Eilish's song Listen Before I Go introduces us to, at its opening seconds, alongside with delicate piano chords in the background. And I can bet that when you hear the name Billie Eilish, you probably hear Bad Guy, or Ocean Eyes, or When the Party's Over in your head. But I believe that Listen Before I Go is the most important song she has made this far. So let me explain why I believe it to be true. When compared to other tracks from her debut album, When We Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go? Listen Before I Go is surprisingly minimalistic, or even cautious, in its composition. The main instrument accompanying Billie's voice is the piano, being a little bit muted, like you heard your neighbor playing in a flat next to yours. Alongside with some high-pitched synths and occasional bass drop, that's it. The biggest emphasis in this song is put on Billie Eilish's vocals, and the story she tells us. And the story goes like this. It's about a girl at the brink of giving up her life. I always imagine her standing on the top of a skyscraper in the middle of the night. Her young, miserable face illuminated by the neon glow of the sleeping city beneath her feet. As Billie sings, she seems to talk to someone, but I believe she's all alone up there. And she speaks to her dearest friend only in her head. Take me to the rooftop. I wanna see the world when I stop breathing. Turning blue are the opening words of the lyrics. Further down the way, you can hear lines like I'm not okay, I feel so scattered. Or, if you need me, wanna see me, better hurry, cause I'm leaving soon. In the repeating pre-chorus part of the song. We don't get to know what specific events in her life got the main character of this story to this dramatic scene, but I don't think it's that important. When it comes to me, my guts tell me that what really matters here is her standing so close to the edge of that skyscraper, about to end her life with one jump. I can almost imagine her standing there, on that ledge, breezy wind moving her t-shirt. Sorry, there's no way out, but down. And I can almost see her making that one last jump. In the final part of the song, which is at the same time the emotional crescendo of it all, there are a few brief lyric lines that moved or saddened me the most of all the music I've listened to in my life. I think they represent quite neatly what a suicidal person might think or feel in the final moments of their existence. The struggling contrast of those lines always managed to tear my heart apart every time I listen to this song. And I always imagine them floating desperately in the girl's, our main character's, head as she falls to her death, her hair uncontrollably twisting in the hurting wind. How long does it take to reach the ground from the top of a skyscraper? How long do the final words of "Listen Before I Go" vibrate in the girl's head before she dies? The final words being, "Call my friends and tell them that I love them and I'll miss them, but I'm not sorry." And then they immediately repeat, although with a tiny alteration, "Call my friends and tell them that I love them and I'll miss them. Sorry." It's the last word you can hear in this song, but it doesn't end yet. If you listen closely after the music stops, you will hear three distant sounds. First, a bass-like accent as the girl's body met the ground. And after that, barely audible, woman's hysteric scream, as if she actually witnessed our main character's last jump, ending. And then, the last sound of the song, the sirens of an ambulance, approaching. I lost my friend. He was a rat, and his name was Kudu. But me and my girlfriend mostly called him Grubcio. It more or less translates to fatty in English. There wasn't an animalistic thing about him. He loved to eat and take naps with us, and he loved to hug and be petted. He practically slept every night in our bed. He would come running to you if you said his name. He was nothing but love. He was special. And we loved him back. We decided to put Grubcio to sleep because he couldn't walk anymore. He had problems with his teeth and his spine, and we didn't want him to suffer and for him to stay himself till the very end. Buried him under a humble pine tree near my girlfriend's parents' house, where he lived most of his life. We visit him till this day. The time after his death was easily the hardest of my life. I couldn't find a way to be happy without him. The feeling of emptiness that I felt was overbearing. Rats normally live between 2 and 2.5 years. He lived 2 years and 1 month. He really loved living. And the most overwhelming thought I had that time was that I will never have anything like that again in my life. There are things no money can buy, and that was one of them. I won't ever get a chance to hug Grubcio again. I won't ever see him taking all his medicine, like it was the yummiest candy in the world. I won't ever feel how warm his little body was, how soft and of how pleasant to smell his fur was. All of that has been gone from the day he died. It was the 21st March 2020, around 4 p.m. From then on, our Grubcio lives only in our memory. He was my best buddy. There is not a single day that I don't miss him. That's why I dedicated this season to him. I wanted to give him something only from me, that only I could do. Thank you for being my friend, Grubcio. I'm sure we'll meet again, someday.
Go that dark with this song? Are you seriously implying that you jump off the roof? Do you feel okay about a song like that? You don't worry about that?
I feel like it's something I want to have said.
You don't worry about
this song is the reason I don't. Like, having this way of saying it instead of doing it is better.
Excuse me for this sudden personal left turn, but I truly believe that it's essential to what this episode is about. Because I lost a friend. And I am somebody's friend. And you have friends. And you are somebody's friend.
No.
So let's do that like 17 times.
And I cannot pray Billie Eilish enough for coming out with her depression and suicidal thoughts. That is also why I believe Listen Before I Go to be the crucial song of her career so far.
So dark, like, have happy music. I'm like, what? I'm never feeling happy, so why would I write about things I don't know about? You know, I feel the dark things, I feel them very strongly, and you know, why would I not talk about them? You know what I'm saying?
Because she gave an example.
I never was like, I'm gonna talk about this and I'm gonna talk about this. I just talked about what I was feeling and talked about why it was bad or why it was good or why it was whatever, and then it became this like, oh, she's making a statement, which I actually love because I didn't realize I was. And now that I think about it, like, I realize how many people aren't talking about that kind of stuff and why people are so, like, shocked when you do talk about it. I'm like, why is that so shocking? Like, I'm telling you, like, about how I am as a human. Like, why is that weird?
And continues to give it every single day.
To be honest with you, I didn't think I would make it to this age. There it is. This page was kind of like the peak, I would say. I was like 14, 15. I had razors hidden in places, and I had Band-Aids hidden in a little corner of my room, and I always had Band-Aids on my wrists.
I was literally locking myself in the bathroom and making myself bleed because I thought I deserved it, you know?
It's okay to feel bad. It's okay to be depressed. It's okay to be suicidal. It's okay to ask your friend if they feel bad. It's okay to ask them if they are depressed. To ask them if they are suicidal. It's okay to confess to feeling bad, to being depressed, to being suicidal. It's okay for your friends to confess to all of those things. And it's okay to ask for help, or to get help for your friend. The only thing that is not okay is to lose a friend. That is not okay at all. Depression might turn out to be a deadly illness because it might bring suicidal thoughts along the way. And it's getting more and more common among younger and younger people. So don't you go to that rooftop in the middle of the night. Don't you stand near that edge. Don't let yourself lose your friend. Don't let your friends lose you. Just ask if your friend needs help. Just ask for help. Just ask. Because it's okay. It's okay.
It's okay.
In my moved mind. And that's it for season 4, Musicology. Sorry if it was a bit too personal, and you're welcome if it was too personal. And yeah, I know, it's been a long time coming. Mostly I could get around 15 to 30 minutes of editing per day, and that really slowed me. I thought that after maybe 2 months, all of my subscribers would be long gone. But you weren't. It's so nice. I didn't really like that you had to wait for so long for next moved stuff, so I came up with some bonus episodes, as always, but there is new stuff coming, definitely, and I hope you will like it as well. Yes, and I really need to thank the incredible special guests of this season. Pink Palace, like, those guys from Boston, they are really, really incredible musicians that somehow happened to just get convinced to join me on this final episode. Thanks guys, I love you and your music. May it spread all over the world like wildfire. Now I am off to do some work on season 5. It's going to be the big one. See you soon. Bye. No i oczywiście dziękuję też Tobie, polski widzu. Też chciałbym podziękować Bartkowi Sobczyńskiemu za fenomenalną robotę i tłumaczeniową, i napisową, bo to dzięki niemu możesz doświadczać poruszonego umysłu z tak pięknie przygotowanymi napisami. Przygotowałem specjalny polski odcinek bonusowy, który właściwie jest następny w grafiku i jestem bardzo ciekaw, co o nim powiesz. Ale żeby nie przedłużać, i tak te odcinki wychodzą mi coraz dłuższe. Za każdym razem, kiedy klikniesz w mój filmik, to sprawia, że moje marzenie trochę ożywa. Dlatego dziękuję Ci za to. Czekam z niecierpliwością, aż odkryjesz wszystkie nowości, które zaplanowałem na etap po sezonie 4, na jak zareagujesz na sezon 5. Dlatego życzę teraz miłego wieczoru. Dbajcie o swoich przyjaciół. Pytajcie i proście. Dzięki.